so much. Thank you to every one of you for being here today. This is an honor to me. This project began almost 2 years ago when Mrs. Sawyer and I were talking, and I said, oh my goodness, I would love to be just more involved with the school. I have been somehow. But you know what is the beautiful thing in life? If we are patient, everything we want to happen happens. If we are patient. And today we are celebrating this moment. So gracias por estar aquí. Gracias por estar aquí. When people look at me, they think I am an American woman. I was born in here, right? I am an American now because I became an American citizen, but I am originally from Colombia. My first language is Spanish. And I just enjoy being Latina. I love that. But there is too many things I would like to share with you today because life is happening right now. Well, we are here. Oh, lots of things are happening out there. Lots of things. Here on the field, there is a game. But if you think, for example, about the, let's say, the observatory. If you go to Tucson, there are 7 big, enormous buildings. That's the observatory. Do you all speak English a little bit? Are you understanding what I am just saying?
Yes.
Are you understanding?
I do.
You don't speak English?
No.
This is a motivation for you today. This is a motivation. I'm going to ask you, Mayra, the whole time while I am speaking, hold your husband's hand. Please. Oh my gosh. Just connect yourself. And if you want to get closer and hug yourself, just do that. Don't be surprised if in the middle of the presentation I begin to cry. Because I am feeling all of you. Don't feel, my eyes are almost in tears right now. This moment, este momento, señor, usted lo va a recordar. Conecte con su esposa. Si es posible, acérquese a ella en este momento y abrácense. Porque lo necesito, necesito que la energía vaya al 100% y que se lleve hasta el techo. Thank you. Stay like that. The whole time. And Janet is going to be taking pictures of you, okay?
No, no problem.
Yes. Because this is inspiration. I want to say thank you to the parents. But I also want to say thank you to the kids. So, what is your name? Emilio, mi amor. Oh my gosh, Emilio, how nice to see you here today. So, what is your name, amor? Bueno, ¿cuál es el nombre?
Sabina.
Además, nombre mágico, ¿cierto? Yeah. Sabina. Oh, what is your name?
Zion.
That's a beautiful name. That's a beautiful name. Without them, we would not be invited here. We are invited here because we are parents. It's because of them. So let's consider them our miracles. Our miracles. Let's consider them our opportunity to grow up through them. Ellos son nuestra oportunidad de crecer a través de ellos. That's what they are. So sometimes we are impatient with them. But it's not a good thing to do. Because we are more experienced than them. and we are older than them, and we know better. We know better, right? So there is too many things I would like to share with you. This is motivation, this is empowerment, this is, oh my gosh, why am I here? Not only in this classroom today, but in life. Why am I here today? What is the purpose of me being here? What is the purpose? What is my mission? What is my mission? I know a lot of people that comes to my workshop and they are, excuse me for the expression, almost dying, like finishing, and they don't know their mission. They don't have any idea about their mission. But I know people also that is old enough and they don't know the ocean. They have seen the ocean on television, but since they haven't been there, they truly don't believe it's real. They don't believe it's real. So the first invitation I'm gonna make you today is think on one place you would like to go, and you have been thinking for a long time, oh, one day I'm going to the ocean. One day, when is that day gonna happen if you don't pick a date on the calendar? You need to pick a day on the calendar. Si su sueño es hacer un viaje y ha venido planeando por mucho tiempo hacer un viaje, no va a suceder a menos que usted seleccione un día en el calendario. I have no money to go on a trip. Excuse. And a lot of people need excuses. A lot of people. There is no excuses. You know why we are living, and we are so lucky, living close to California. And we all have at least one car in our house. Por lo menos un carro tenemos. So just think on a date. Think on a month of the year. November, December, too busy, right? Thanksgiving is coming. Christmas is coming. A lot of expenses, maybe not. But what about beginning the year, getting into the car and going to California? Just driving to California, right? Oh my gosh. And after accomplishing that, there is a second goal we are going to accomplish. And you know what is the biggest problem? We have no goals. We have no goals. No tenemos metas. Ese es el problema. Thank you. We are, especially when we have kids, everything for my kid. Everything for my kid. So if in the kid's mind doesn't exist a trip to California, you don't go to California. Because it is like they are the ones who dictate where I am going next. And that's not what I am here for today. To motivate you to sacrifice and to keep sacrificing yourself. Yo no estoy aquí para pedirles que se sacrifiquen y que se sigan sacrificando. I am here to invite you to live life today, right now, right now, right now. We are going to pronounce, I am, and my name, and this is what I do, okay? Lo vamos a decir en inglés, lo vamos a decir en español. Vamos a pronunciar, este es mi nombre y qué es lo que hago. Voy a comenzar, I'm gonna begin for us to have the example, okay? I am Aracelis Gonzalez de McCain. That's my name. That's not who I am. Right? I am a transformational life coach. That's my profession. That's not what I am. Are you getting that? I am peace. I am tranquility. I am love. That's who I am. I am light. That's who I am. I am peace. I am tranquility. I am love. That's who I am. And you are gonna be feeling it more and more and more as the time passes. You are gonna be feeling it. You are gonna feel that feeling the whole body, because that's what we need. So you are first on my right. You are gonna begin. What is your name? What do you do? You?
Me? My name is Ernesto.
Ernesto.
Yes, I'm working for the construction.
For construction, oh my gosh. I honor your presence, not only in my life, but in the United States life. Once I was watching this movie about who built United States of America. It's a beautiful movie. And then I was watching this documentary about New York. People coming from all over the world and building New York. Have you been in New York? Not yet. You need to go. That's a goal. It doesn't matter if that takes 10 years or 15. Write it in a paper. I'm going to New York. Okay? And just to be there is a fantastic energy. But just understanding who built New York, I am so proud. Because immigrants from all over the world built the most beautiful city in my concept here in the United States. What is your name? What do you do?
Mi nombre es María. Yo soy Ama de Casa.
Okay. This is supposed to be the most difficult career in the world. Being
so stressful.
Housewife. So stressful, right? So yeah. Stressful. So I'm going to remind you, Maria, I am peace, I am tranquility, and I am love. And I am going to ask you to let the stress go out as my words touch you. So consciously let your shoulders get relaxed. Yes, just like a feel like the earth is drawing you. It's taking you down, like your shoulders are going down. Whenever you feel any effort on your side, just get relaxed. If you are in your tippy toes now, no. Yeah, exactly. You see? Get relaxed. Because this is a moment for you, okay? Ernesto, Maria. Mi amor, Emilio. Thank you for being here, Emilio. You look very, very smart, and I like that. I always love being in front of smart people. You are awake. Those big, ginormous, open eyes, I love them. You are awake, and that's good. And when I mention the expression, you are awake, it's not like, oh, he went out of bed. Yes, he is awake. No, your soul is just aware of things. And you are very smart. I love you here, okay? Mayra, un poquito, por favor, de información. What is your name and what do you do?
My name is Mayra, and I'm a respiratory therapist. Me llamo Mayra y soy terapista respiratoria.
Oh my goodness! Thank you for being here. Respiratory therapist. Sometimes it is like our chest is so congested that we cannot breathe. But it's not only because we got a cold. Sometimes life is so overwhelming that we cannot breathe. So when that is happening, our life is being interrupted. And we are not going with the flow. You know what I mean, okay? We are not going with the flow. ¿Qué sucede cuando nosotros dejamos de respirar bien? La vida se nos va de las manos. Respirar es supremamente importante para todos nosotros. Aparentemente los niños no están participando, pero sí están participando. Do you speak Spanish? Muy poquito. So, to honor her, we are going to keep the dynamic, okay? When we stop breathing, life goes out of our hands. So, how important is to breathe? Just breathing. And go with the flow is very important. So, here where you are, sitting in the place you are, we are going to be conscious on our breathing. Just be conscious on our breathing. Allí donde estamos, vamos a empezar a ser conscientes de nuestra respiración ahora. We are gonna be conscious. So we are gonna take the air through our nose. And we are going very, very, very slow to begin to bring more and more and more and more air inside us in this moment. And we are going to begin to feel how our stomach gets expanded because it's being filled with the air. Algo que vamos a hacer en este momento es que vamos a ser conscientes de nuestra respiración. Vamos a empezar a tomar aire por nuestra nariz muy lentamente y vamos a sentir cómo el aire nos va llenando hasta llegar a nuestro estómago y vamos a sentir cómo el estómago se expande. Cuando estemos allí, entonces vamos a empezar a botar el aire lento, lento, lento por la nariz y vamos a sentir que nos relajamos, que nos soltamos. When the air gets into our stomach, we are going to begin to breathe that air out and we are going to be conscious about the fact that everything that is negative is leaving our body, okay? Like stress, like are you tired, for example? Yes, that needs to leave and allow the energy to come in. Like the worriedness, are you worried about anything? Like, are you sick? So, when I breathe, I take air, which means life. Do you agree? Air is life. If we don't breathe, we die. So, what is the air for us? It's life. So, if I am needing enough life inside the illness, we begin to disappear. You know what I mean? Cuando respiramos conscientemente, estamos trayendo vida a nuestro ser, a nuestro cuerpo. Y si nosotros conscientemente permitimos que la preocupación, el estrés, la enfermedad, todo eso que nos impide empiece a salir, nosotros empezamos a energizarnos, empezamos a sentirnos mejor. ¿Qué les parece si simplemente allí donde estamos empezamos a aplicar respiración? It's okay if we just begin to breathe in this moment. Go ahead. Yeah, in the place we are. Just be consciously. Very slow. Feel yourself with the air. Bring the air to your stomach. Keep it there for a little bit. And then let the air go out. Very slow. Let's do it again. Vamos a hacerlo nuevamente. Pero en esta oportunidad, vamos a cerrar los ojos. Now we are going to close our eyes. We are doing it. And just avoid any tension. I love how you are doing that. You are connecting. Get closer, get closer, because one day you are going to understand that you as a family are one. You are one. And keep it like that. Yeah. You can hold your hands like this, okay. Like husband and wife, okay? Yes. You are one. We are gonna begin to breathe consciously, okay? Stay there. Consciously. Close eyes. Just enjoy the ride, okay? Slow, lento, profundo to the tummy. And then take your time and breathe out. Everything, the pain, the hatred, the suffering, everything that you don't need anymore is going out. If you no longer need it, let it go. And this is just beautiful. Now, staying there, close eyes, we are gonna take the deepest breathing possible. Get relaxed. Yes, we need this. Yeah. We need it. How beautiful. On your own time, breathe again. En tu propio tiempo, vuelve a empezar el proceso de respiración. Closing our eyes is very, very important because in that way, we don't allow the situations from the outside to distract us. There is a lot of distractions out there. Lot of distractions. I want to thank Mrs. Smith and every single teacher because you make possible for us to be more relaxed than you can be. I cannot imagine. Every single day, my kid with me. And I love him. You know what I am saying. Amamos a nuestros hijos, pero le tenemos que agradecer a los profesores porque ellos son los que están absorbiendo todo ese estrés. Y para acabar de ajustar, les ponen aquí, I don't know, like 25 or 30 kids. 25 or 30, that's a lot. So you are an angel for us. Thank you so much. This is a recognition, okay? ¿Cómo te sentiste, Ernesto?
Muy bien.
Muy bien, ¿verdad? María, ¿cómo te sentiste?
También, relajada.
Relajada, ¿verdad? That was just a minute. How did you feel?
Relajada.
You are an expert on that. You are an expert. But sometimes we are doing it to another people and we forget about ourselves. ¿Cómo te sentiste?
Muy bien.
Muy bien, ¿verdad? How did you feel?
Good. My back popped.
You see, okay, that was good.
I took a deep breath and I was like, ooh.
Yes, thank you so much. Went out. Yeah. But here is the wonderful thing. You can do that whenever you need it. Like you go to the bathroom in the middle of the day. Just sit down there for that to fall down. Sit down and breathe. It can be 3 minutes, it can be 5 minutes, and it's gonna be magical for you. Magical. Puede ser 3 minutes o 5 minutes y va a ser mágico para cada uno de nosotros. And we need to do that. Please come in. We need to do that. So breathing is really important, right? Because it's a way for us to re-energize ourselves. Is the way we re-energize. Yeah. But you know what? Sleeping is also very important. I'm talking to parents. I'm talking to adult people having kids that cannot sleep as you want because they get up very early, they go to sleep very late, stuff like that. Welcome. And you need to rest. It's very important for your energy to stay and for your energy to recover. Duerma bien. Los niños se acuestan muy tarde, se levantan muy temprano, pero usted necesita dormir, porque es una forma, otra forma de mantenerse energizado. We need that. You know what? I have to tell you. Forever, I have been meditating like for 20, 30 years. When I came to the United States to marry my husband, from the very beginning, I began to ask for my time just to meditate. I have never asked. I just said, I need a nap. It doesn't matter what time is it, I need a nap. So in the beginning, it was only the mother and the father without the kid. And then the kid came, and I kept saying, I need a nap. But now the mother was no longer alone. Now the father asked the kid, go to watch television upstairs or go to do something because your mom needs a nap. And then the husband was so happy to help the wife that the husband began to turn the TV on a relaxation music channel. But the kid was so little, he couldn't understand what was going on. And then, someday, when the time was right, the mother said, I need to take a nap. And suddenly, the kid took the control, the TV control, and searched for the relaxation music channel because he was seeing his dad doing the same thing. Lo que les estoy diciendo es que nosotros como padres educamos a los hijos. This is what I am saying. We, as parents, educate our kids. Whatever they see us doing, they are gonna repeat sooner or later. Sooner or later. So now my kid looks for the music for me to be able to do my meditation. And you know why I am mentioning this today? Because we deserve. And this is for you, my young lady. We deserve. Muchas veces nos casamos y nos olvidamos de nosotros hasta tal punto que empezamos a sentir que no merecemos. Y sí merecemos. We deserve. So you need some help. Ask for help. Because you deserve. And you are beautiful. You are like a Pocahontas, okay? So you deserve. You came right on time. Sometimes you feel just overwhelmed. It's because you need help. And you need to learn how to ask for help. Because screaming is not asking. Nobody is helping me. I don't know what to do. That's not the way. Asking is not screaming. And screaming is not asking. And be very careful. Because they are receiving everything. We are angry, they receive it. We are feeling abandoned, they will feel it. And they will repeat it. They will repeat it. I am so happy to have you here. Stay with us. Stay with us. This is wonderful. ¿Cómo te estás sintiendo?
Tranquilo.
Tranquilo, ¿verdad? aunque no hablas inglés, ya sabes lo que estoy haciendo. No te estoy tirando por la borda. Te estoy alimentando, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Are you? You are just coming here. How are you feeling?
Good.
Good. You know why? Because I was sure to connect with her right in the moment she came, right? It's a lot. You are an angel and you are peaceful. You are peaceful. You have character, you have your character, but you are peaceful and you are doing something not everybody is able to do, okay? Yes. Yes.
People tell me that. I'm like, thanks. Yeah, I hope I'm doing it right.
You are patient. You are patient. That's beautiful. Thank you so much. Amor, what is your name? Jesus Alejandro. So you know what? Jesus, we know Jesus and what he did, right? For the whole humanity, he saved us. And Alejandro, like Alexander, is the protector of the humanity. That's what that means. So you have a great kid and a great daughter over there, okay? They are great. You are just great. I am very happy to meet you today, okay, Jesus Alejandro? I'm so happy to be here with you today, okay? Thank you for coming. And sometimes we think, oh, I don't need this. I don't need things like this. We do.
Yeah.
We do. And you are getting relaxed, and you are going to be more and more relaxed. And when you go outside, you are going to see the sun is like shining better than before. And you are going to be feeling good the whole day, the whole weekend, the whole week. I promise you. I promise you. Gracias a que vino aquí hoy, se va a estar sintiendo bien todo el día. Y todo el fin de semana. Y toda la semana. Eso es una promesa.
Gracias.
Drinking water. Drinking water, because we are learning how to live better, right? Drink water. Because in our composition, in our body composition, there is more or less 60% water. Water. That's a powerful energizer for us. It doesn't mean because we can get sick when we drink a lot of water, right? But doctor says 8 bottles of water per day would be enough. But sometimes we are not even drinking one. You know that. Tomar agua es muy importante porque también es un energizante. But you know what the water can do for us? Emilio, amor, thank you for being here. When we get up, sometimes we go to sleep, and we sleep all night long, let's say more than 8 hours. And in the morning, we are even more tired than we were the night before. Les ha sucedido, ¿verdad? Que muchas veces dormimos toda la noche y nos levantamos y estamos más cansados. Aquí está la gran oportunidad. Here is the great opportunity. Go to the shower. And just feel like that water is touching you, is cleaning you, and is just renewing your energy. Entonces la gran oportunidad es que al ducharse sienta, por favor, que ese agua lo está tocando, lo está limpiando y lo está energizando. Y siempre después de tomar la ducha, nos sentimos más despiertos. Always, after taking the shower, we are more awake. Did you notice that? So never go out of the house without taking the shower. Because we need to be awake, truly awake and aware of things when we go out. It's a lot going on out there, right? So we are breathing, we are drinking water, we are sleeping, and we are eating well. Eating well. Let's become experts just eating well. That's why it's very well recommended, the vegetables, because they are fresh from the garden. You go to Fry's or you go to Food City and they don't sell old vegetables. They sell fresh vegetables, right? Do you like vegetables?
No.
At this age, it's hard. It's hard, I understand. Do you like vegetables? You do, congratulations, mi amor. Congratulations. Emily, do you like vegetables?
Nah.
Sabina, do you like vegetables? You too! Congratulations. Ladies won at this moment. Do you like vegetables? You too, you see? Do you like vegetables?
Yeah.
You do?
He likes lettuce.
Lettuce, okay. But it's very good for us, okay? It's very good for all of us. That's for the body. What is for our soul? What is for our soul? Now we know how to breathe. Now we know that we can relax doing that. Now we know how effective this moment we are taking for us is, right? Something very important is to stay open-minded. To stay open-minded. To receive and to see new possibilities. Whenever we do this, we are blocking ourselves. So I can be speaking for you the whole day, but that closing thing is stopping my energy from going to you. You see, that little thing, just exactly, this, for example, is good. We can be seated, like with hands over here or just on top of the table. It's like me trying to go there, but having this table over here. You know what I mean? A veces nos bloqueamos a nosotros mismos e impedimos que lo bueno nos llegue. Bueno en términos de energía.